intermission.
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. On second down, Ryan. He gets it to Baldwin. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Well, if you want to be known as dependable to your quarterback, that's what you have to do. Go into the middle of the field, know the hit is coming, and catch the football. And that's exactly what he just got done.
And defensively, a little deflating to be able to lay that hit and not have the ball pop free, right?
No doubt about it, because your goal...
There goes Mark Ingram. Touchdown, Vikings. Mark Ingram with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Vikings are able to strike for 6. And that makes it 14-10. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number 2. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to get themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. A 3-yard pickup on 2nd and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on 3rd and a little more than a yard. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was 3rd and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And they're going to face a 3rd down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now a play fake, and it's gone. And he finds a man with a crossing route. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. They run with Hunt. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
And he'll give it here to his running back. No dice this go-around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Goff being chased out left. And he's got Strome. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first, this one from 40 yards out. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the lead is down to one now at 14-13. A decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged three out of it, but they do inch a bit closer.
Yeah, still lots of time to go in this one. Take the points, move on, and let your defense try to get the ball back.
Here on first down. Baldwin with it over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a one-point difference. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Try to run some clock with Ingram. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
And for one of the few times here today, this one's not going to go anywhere. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. They go screen. This is Ingram. And he is going to lose yardage here. They lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to fourth down. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
So a change of possession here on the punt, and this offense is going to take over at their own 20-yard line. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. On second down, here's Goff. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. They'll fake the give. Now gone. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A gain of 32 that time. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, that all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this.
So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A great play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Chiefs have taken the lead here in the fourth.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get over-eager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Bailey now to kick this one away. This one taken from the 7. Matt Ryan and the offense heading back onto the field. This is something we've seen many times over the course of his career. Can he pull off another fourth quarter comeback?
And it's very strange, isn't it? Because when it's a player of this magnitude, even though the guys on defense have the lead and are sitting in the best spot, they're maybe the most nervous people in the stadium because they've seen this happen to too many people before, too many teams. They've got to find a way to shut him down.
Here we go again for the grizzled vet. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
They'll look to throw. He goes underneath to Ingram, and he'll get up to the 43-yard line. That'll be a gain of 15 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. He's back to throw. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin, and he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Back to throw. Throw left side complete. It's Baldwin. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. He'll look to throw. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute, and they're an extra point away from tying this game. So getting the big touchdown they needed late in the fourth, now what do? You conservative and just tie it up?
No, I think you put your practice into game situation. Go as fast as possible. You already have your play call ready to go. Go for 2 and decide it right now.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Goff. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Couple extra defensive backs out there in the dive, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You having to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. The Chiefs on third down. Six conversions and nine tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This will be third and 15. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. That would have been a tough catch, but in this two-minute drill, those are the ones you really hope your guys come up with.
Yeah, you don't want your guy to be able to take the out because it was a tough catch. You needed him to come up with that one, because if he does, it alters the perspective of this two-minute drill, doesn't it?
And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks near the 25. The game's gone final in Indianapolis. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Brett Hundley, two touchdown passes in the W. A 10th carry here for Mark Ingram. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. To throw is Ryan. He's going to air this out for Baldwin. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
On second down, Ingram. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
But if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, a guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Lava's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Now a handoff to Ingram. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about six.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position end up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
It's third and four. Big play here, trying to keep this opening drive of overtime alive. Now it's Ryan. He finds his man, Baldwin. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. So he hooked up with a veteran there, and in overtime, That's not a bad idea. Go with the age and the experience.
Yeah, because sometimes the young guys, they give you the fresh legs and give you all that bounce. But in this type of a situation, sometimes his legs slow down a little bit as the enormity of the moment overwhelms them. The veteran guys, they tend to come through.
And he's brought down. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Shaping up to be a very efficient opening drive here in overtime.
And can you feel the tension building? Because I'm feeling it, all right? I've got the sweaty palms here with each play because of the enormity of what's going on. Each play means so much in overtime, and they're handling it well as this drive continues.
A gain of 3, second down.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
Now Ryan on second down. Oh, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. Room here to run. Past the 20. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a KC touchdown. Still catching our breaths from that electric finish. You get into overtime, that's one thing. It was a great four quarters. But then an OT, not only to win it, but to win it on a defensive score. Wow.
Oh, definitely. And I think from now on, we're going to definitely travel someone who can help us because I thought I was going to pass out at the end. Not just getting to the overtime, but the plays in overtime that led to this one and to finish it on a defensive touchdown, a takeaway that gets into the end zone. I'm not rooting for anyone, but boy, I'd love to see games finish that way.
Young Gerald. Yeah. 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 Die line with the boom pow. Every week now I switch to a new style. 212s in the back just blew out. Everything I do end up in the news now. Yeah. Lead a club with a few now. Just some Hollywood and they do. I'm in the mood now. 2 a.m. What you wanna do now?
What you wanna do now?
Lil baby, pass. Don't spill on me, that's Marcella. Got this Oakland game to tell her. She look familiar. At Coachella, what's her name? Isabella, it's a, forget it, yeah. It's like a week ago, but we both know how weekends go. Tryna flush and got some places we could go. Lot y'all got me speaking slow like, yeah. I'm blessed, I don't GA. I'm tryna, yes on, yes on, yes on, yes. Say less. You ain't go. Say less. Yeah. Say less. Hey, girl, with friends, cool, bring a few through. No fun if the homies now R.I.P. Nate Dogg, this too true. And you know what I'm down for. Round 2, round 3, and a round 4. Move switch when she knocked at the front door. Next up was the uproar. Yeah. Was like a week ago, but we both know how weekends go. Tryna tuck off, got some places we could go. Swear she got the like, wow. She's blessed, I'm blessed. I don't GA. Yes on, yes on, yes on, yes. Say less. Say less. You ain't go. Say less.
Sheesh. What you saying? I don't understand. I'm out my mind. I popped. Sheesh. I swear this lock shot got me stuttering. Girl, you so cute, I fall in love again. Sheesh. Get it, my favorite rush. You talkative, ain't gotta say too much. Be quiet, who got some grapes? I'm trying to I'm on both of these. Get it, not complicated. No conversation. Get it, not complicated. No conversation, please say less, please say less, please say less.
I'm blessed, I don't GA. I'm trying to, yes on, yes on, yes on, yes. Say
You know, I'm like, yeah, nice P, you know?
What up, P?
Man.
The musica de Harry Fry.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things, I bring them things. I call the food, bring them things. Mucho. Bring them things, looking so expensive, rings and things. I bring them things. I bring them things. I bring them things.
Man, you don't want for them, bro. Oh, you, any better get low. Extorting, you ain't got no friends. Oh, they be for that, like a Chanel scarf, like rainbow. $1,000, this ain't your cloth. You ain't, that ain't no sauce. I can see the noodles made for poodles. I'm thinking about the law Ferrari coupe. 1.8, the option is the roof. Greens is a secret to the youth. Your goals are malnourished, please spit the juice. Y'all be vaping, I be maiden. Y'all be aping, I'm Richard Mille Nation.
No diamonds, just tourbillon facing with gears and sprockets with the sapphire casing.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry.
Larry, as always, it is a frenzied atmosphere inside Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Chicago Bears and the Kansas City Chiefs. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Carry now for Kareem Hunt. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line. Hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Now it's Hunt. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He lost two there, and it's third down. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
It's caught, Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there, 26 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
J.J. Watt makes another tackle there, and it's for a minimal gain. And let's face it, if that's all you're going to get running the ball, you're not got much success against him and his team.
Or, yeah, you better find a way to go around J.J. Watt, which isn't easy to do.
It's really not, because you got to try everything. Can you go around him? Can you go by him? Can you influence him to get him out of position so maybe you can wall him off? He's a really sharp, intelligent player, as well as a physical specimen.
Holding offense.
So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
Now on fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's the Chiefs punter now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one hears away. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Southern man, this is Jerick McKinnon. He'll get about three as he's taken down at the 23. Here we go, a second and seven. Here again is McKinnon. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. 23 yards on the play. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk. Crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
They run once more with McKinnon. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain there, and it brings forth a third and long. Third and long, it's Smith. And finding Fedorowicz. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
Brandon, lest my eyes deceive me, I think they found a matchup that they're trying to exploit here, don't you? I mean, that's the second time they've gone to him here on this drive.
Yeah, opening drive. It's a tone setter, right? First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, it'll be second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Here's McKinnon, and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Now it's Smith. And some room to roam now. And that one good for 16 yards and a first. Zone now, Smith, and he's got it over the middle, Fedorowicz, and he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
To throw is Smith, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Call it a gain of three, and that'll bring up a second and goal. McKinnon. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Smith going to throw on third and one. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And Vinatieri's kick is good. And it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. So they get three. They were hoping for six, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. They'll fake the handoff. Now gone. He'll buy some time right. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. And incomplete here on third down. We're back to Arrowhead after this. Goff and his guys not coming off the field. They're going for this. They're going to go for it. It's Goff. Steps away to his left. He may try and run for this. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Now Goff on first down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him eight.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Gone. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. He's got the lane, and there he goes. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people using five defensive back, six defensive back packages, not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
And out come the Chiefs now. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football. I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. They go play action here on first down. Steps away. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. The intended target, the tight end, Austin Seferian Jenkins. And that'll bring up second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Third and two, gone. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
They run for it with Hunt. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short. Well, that was too far for a field goal try. You don't really gain a whole lot out of a punt, so I don't think you have much of a problem with that, do you?
No, not at all. I think it's the right play, the exact right play, because even if you want to play defense and pin them deep, you know how hard it is for a punter to knock one dead inside the 10-yard line. That's not necessarily easily done, so I think going for it there was the right call.
To throw on second down is Smith. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Throwing on third down, Smith. Right side, caught, Fedorowicz. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
He punted five times in the win last week as this one's away. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
Value three.
A final shot before break here. Goff looking deep for Julio. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we reach halftime with a visiting... Sorry, Larry, your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today as we get back to the action in the second half. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Oh, look at the juke. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. That good for 22 and a first down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
That's caught, Fedorowicz. And he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and it'll be second and 12.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Second down, here's Smith. Down his man, Robbie Anderson. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Robbie Anderson with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Bears will add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
So the drive there took 6 plays, and the end result is a Bears touchdown. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. He's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second half?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Holding offense.
Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
Now a play fake here on first down. And Olsen over the middle. And he gets this one all the way up to the 40-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. So here we go, first and 10 now. Off play action, here's Goff. He's gonna fire one deep left sideline. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll fake the give. Now gone. Out to his left. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
The Chiefs on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 9. Out of the gun. Gone. Forced out to his left. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Able to find a lot of empty space there, picking up the first down at a 21-yard gain.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. That one goes for 36 yards. Great footwork there, Charles, to dot the I, stay in bounds, get both feet in. He's probably thinking, though, man, I made a catch like that close to the end zone, I should have scored.
Yeah, there's always a regret when you're that close to the goal line. But let's go back to what you talked about before, getting his feet down. Would you say dotting the I? Mm-hmm. I can cross the T as well. That was excellent footwork to get in bounds and make a great catch.
Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run.
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball first down in this situation.
And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs are able to draw a bit closer. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
That one goes for 24 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. We're back now in KC. They run it with McKinnon. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push him back more. From the gun, here's Smith. And he's got it, Fedorowicz. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. C.J. Fedorowicz, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bears will extend their lead. And nowadays in NFL football, you have to account for all the receivers, sure, but the tight end's such a weapon, and they prove it right there.
Oh, without a doubt. And we're seeing now the golden age of tight ends catching the football. I go back to Kellen Winslow. Uh-huh. To me, he was the prototype of what we're seeing today. We're seeing it each and every week now.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Play action, it's gone. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Reuben Foster able to use that strength and get him for a loss of two.
That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number one. And, you know, they had five last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback.
And got his man complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. 23 yards on the play. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Goff on first down. Flushed out right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. J.J. Watt in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. Here's Goff now on second down. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back, out of the back.
And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. He's doing his part, but still facing a sizable deficit.
And he would like to do more. But he needs help from the other two-thirds, right? He needs his defense to bow up a little bit. And he also needs special teams to maybe create some big plays and help them get back in it.
Bailey now to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, getting to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
So that'll back him up five. And he'll give it here to his running back. Room to run past midfield. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That'll set them back with a loss of three on the play. And they'll be facing a third and 12. And they give this time to the tailback. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line. Meanwhile, in Foxborough, they're in the fourth quarter. And the Giants, they wind up winning that one. Phillip Rivers, he was the story there with four touchdown passes. Goff now to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 36. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find the spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Down to a knee, here goes Smith, and that should all but do it. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week.
I stay myself, I never change, yeah. Do whatever gets you paid, yeah.
But I still long. Got 100 different in my cell phone. Still 33, 4 long. Ride to my dog, sitting in jail. Spin it back, roll. I'm on Keller, I'm on Bishop, I'm on Flash. I'm at Magic, I'm at Polish, let them go. Then it's right back to the, win them, low. Rocks never close and we wide open. Kicking flavor with me, neighbor, yeah, we local. Rap the bottom, cause the bottom where we come from. Me no pray for little paper, need a lump sum. Real spill, yeah, oh.